Chanel, a housemate leaving the house is a complicated process, and in order to facilitate your request, you must return to the house and discuss this with your fellow housemate.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Hurry out. I'm going home. Getting my suitcase ready.
No.
I'm going home. I don't want to talk about it.
No.
I don't want people to think I'm selfish, and I don't want people to think I'm doing it for attention, because I'm not. I miss my family. I can't live in here with people who hate me like Charlie. No. And no, it's not about the task. I just want to go home.
Okay. Just give me 2 minutes with you.
No. They've told me I've got to come back out and let you know. So I'm letting you know. And don't want you to begrudge me against it. And you won't fail the test for me doing it.
Chanel.
No. You can't talk me
around.
It's
irrelevant.
Because
I'm
going.
I want to talk to you.
Well, don't try and talk me out of it, because you can't.
It doesn't have to perform.
Joe, leave it.
Okay. Fuck the task then. You know, it's not important.
She got the Zyra now.
Will you talk to me?
No, not. You don't try and change my mind.
Why are you going home?
I'm fucking sick of that stupid little bitch.
You're going to leave over her?
Yes, I am.
You're going to leave here over her?
Yes.
You'll regret this.
I don't care. I'm leaving.
You'll regret this, really, you will.
I will not regret it.
Chanel, it's a silly decision over one person.
I'm fucking sick of her. I can't live with her, and I can't live with people who think I'm selfish because it's the
No.
Think I'm selfish, and it's not me being selfish, it's me being scared shitless.
Sit down and talk to me.
No!
Sit down and talk to me. Listen, give me that bit of respect that we spent this time with each other, then sit down and talk to me. Really? Okay, fuck the task. Yeah? Let's think about you here for 1 second.
Right, I've done 8 weeks. I'm proud of myself.
Fine. Get that leaving thing that you wanted, and you've probably dreamed of whilst you've been in here.
No.
Yes, you do.
What?
So you can
see.
No, it's not tomato straight in your face. So you can talk about your experience. You can talk about what you liked and what you disliked.
I can tell my friends about that.
Well, that's fine. If that's really how you feel, you'll be silly. You will regret this.
I came here maybe
to leave over Charlie.
Over
Charlie. Someone who in my eyes doesn't have a patch on you. You'd be ridiculous to go.
Right. Well, I suppose that I'm ridiculous then, because I'm going.
Why are you being an ass?
I'm not. Not been an arse. Everyone's had messages from home. You've had Molly in. I'm so happy that you have.
I know, but this is what they do, though. They give you ups and downs.
When have I ever had an up?
You're having
when
an up. You're getting up now. Nice. You're getting up.
No, I won't. They're making me do the scariest thing ever. You always say to me, oh, why don't you play the violin? I'm like, I tell you, I've never played it in front of anybody.
Okay, well, you know why they put that on this? Because you probably put it on your application form. You probably said, this is what I do, this is what I can do. So this is what they're going to use.
Yeah, well, do you know what? I'm not going to let them use it. I'm not.
I have to dance around to probably the cheesiest pop song that's ever been created. And dance. Do you hear dance? I dance like my dad.
But that's...
At a wedding.
You can make a joke out of that. I can not do it in front of all these people. The thought makes me feel like I want to throw up. I am leaving, no matter what.
Okay. Fine.
That's it. 7:10 PM. Brian and Amanda are in the garden.
What is the meat in chili con carne? Is it like...
Minced beef.
Is it minced beef? Oh, I thought it was like, that's a weird sort of minced beef, don't it? It's not normal minced beef.
It's just that spaghetti bolognese.
Yeah, but it's not that. It's more tiny than spaghetti bolognese mince. It's like, I don't know. I thought it was like, I don't know, like vegetarian. I didn't know there was it. To be honest, I didn't actually think it was real meat in chili con carne.
Nasty Judge Tracy and nice Judge Sam are in the bedroom. As part of today's talent show, housemates have been provided with costumes.
There's wonders in my figure.
Jerry, Chanel, Ziggy and Liam are at the dining table.
I'm sorry I said you were selfish, I probably shouldn't have said that.
No, Liam, that's your opinion, isn't it? It's a shame that you think that, because we have lived together 24 hours a day now for a long time. And if I was in your shoes, would probably understand that I'm not selfish and I do things for other people, but maybe you can't see that, which is a big shame. And
it's not that I don't see it that you're selfish all the time, I thought that was selfish. All you need to do is scrape a board down a thingy twice and you've performed, whether you do it how you want to play it or whether you just scrape out some notes.
I can't just scrape it out, because that's not having respect for what I've learned.
Two people.
As part of this week's BBTV shopping task, two housemates must come to the diary room within 30 seconds of hearing the BBTV news jingle.
She's great.
Chanel, do you want to go in? In you go.
Oh my god, look, I look like this is Jacob. I look like a big freak.
Have you seen what I look like?
Hello, Liam.
Hello, buddy, Arid.
Hello, Sam.
Hi.
On the floor in front of you are some hampers containing clothes suitable for reading the news in. Please get changed immediately into some suitable attire.
You want me looking at me todger? Oh, crap, I've got no underpants on. I'm not joking, Aus. Okay, let's watch the program now.
Well, good.
They're probably making their mind up what outfits they want to wear.
Yeah, you get the choice out of a boys' or girls' one.
Outfits? Well, a male or female.
Yeah. that's what I'm saying.
Were you supposed to be female yesterday?
No, male.
Oh, right.
What are you saying? What are you saying?
Oh. Here we go.
Liam and Sam must read the BBTV news from an auto-cue placed in front of them.
I don't look at it, she's still got that ear gone.
BBTV.
Yeah.
Is that happening to Joe Day?
Hello and welcome to a very special BBTV news bulletin. I am Liam McGough and I am your anchor.
And I'm Sam, I'm also an anchor.
Oh my god.
An anchor, they're both
singers. Some important news in just from the Big Brother house. Earlier this week, Housemates nominated.
Yeah. Oh, how exciting.
Who they wanted to face for the public vote this Friday. The nominations have been counted. And the housemates who received the most nominations are...
Me.
Tracy.
Oh, that's hilarious.
And... Charlie.
Thank God. Oh, not wow. Being funny, but you're nominated.
Get in.
Oh, fucking hell, wow, I like the picture as well. Oh.
The finalists will be open shortly and the public will decide which one of them will be evicted.
Is that it? Is that the fucking...
Well, then finally, in witness, a man called Paul has grown a cabbage that he swears looks like Ian Beale. Extraordinary.
Be sure to tune in later for all the biggest news as it happens. Oh, goodbye. Yes.
Goodbye.
Is that it?
Ciao, babe.
You want it?
Try, honestly.
We'll see.
I'm not saying, and that sounds so ungrateful to Big Brother, but you don't understand how relaxed I am about it. You don't understand. I'll end up saying things to people that I don't want to look like a bitch when I leave, so I'll say what I've got to say on the door when I leave. If I stay here for a week longer, I'll be very miserable and very rude. And I mean that. I'm not just saying it. No, but I'm not being funny, Carol. I've been saying it all week, I want to go home. I'm not just saying it. I haven't been saying it for the fun or for attention. You can see I really want to go home. I've been in that diary room every single day saying to Big Brother, I feel unhappy here. I don't want to stay no more. I could be honest with you. People that I like have gone. Don't get me wrong, I love you and your sister bits and whoever else. But it's time for me. I really want to go. And I think since I got that message from my mum and that it made me feel better, it made me see that it's all good and that you know, I'm not hated or anything like that. I've been here 8 weeks and it began into my ninth week. I'm happy. Honestly, I'm really happy. You look and see I am. Usually I'll be sitting there like, oh no, I'm really happy to go. And what the fuck, most people did say I was the first to win the million and they said also, I'm going to be remembered in 5 years. That's amazing. Come on. I'm glad. So I will sit here and make someone's life hell when I know that, because I'll be damn right rude. Sick of people in my face talking shit.
Dinner.
Right, let me go and smoke a bowl quickly.
Okay, 8:48 p.m. Brian, Sam, Amanda and Chanel are in the caravan.
That's Big Brother been seeing them.
I said I forgot to think about what I want to do, but I think I want to go... Well, I thought I wanted to go home, but now Charlie's up for eviction, so maybe I don't.
Carol, Charlie and Tracy are in the living area.
What do we know? Do we know if she's going or what?
I don't know.
Oh, she ain't going to go now. I'm up for nomination, is she?
Well, I don't know.
Best thing for her. That person's...
Do we know what she's doing?
Who's Chanel? Yeah. I don't know. She says that she's going to slide later, apparently.
Is she doing the task?
I don't know. Alice is not speaking to
me. Well, if she does, we might fail anyway because we don't know how many fails we've got already.
We're failing if we don't do it.